हेलो एंड वेलकम टू बॉलीवुड वाला। आई एम सोनम। दोस्तों, डेथ नोट एक ऐसा एनिमे सीरीज है जिसको लेकर बहुत सारा रिव्यू रिक्वेस्ट आया था मुझे। दुर्भाग्यवश मैं अब तक यह सीरीज देखा नहीं हूँ। बहुत ही लंबा है, इतने नाम से मैं देखूंगा और इसके बारे में बात करूंगा, लेकिन मेरी स्टूडेंट काव्या एक बहुत बड़ी फैन है इस सीरीज का। आइए उनसे पूछते हैं, उनको ये सीरीज इतना क्यों पसंद है। काव्या, वेलकम टू बॉलीवुड वाला।
हेलो सर।
हाय, माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, टेल मी व्हाट इज इट अबाउट दिस सीरीज दैट मेक्स इट सो वेरी पॉपुलर एंड मेक पीपल गो क्रेजी अबाउट इट।
I think there are three major things. First is the writing.
Okay.
Second, the cinematography and the music. For an animated series to nail all these three points and execute it so well. The plot is one where it is a detective-like story meets fantasy world.
Okay.
So there is one simple tale of a death god.
Okay.
That, you know, comes to take lives, like how we have it in our religion. We believe in death god,
right?
Same, they've taken the same tale in the Japanese culture, that there is a death god and he uses this particular thing in the anime, a death note. That in that he writes names and he takes lives. So whoever's name he writes, the person dies. And that's how he takes the lives of people. What this particular death god named Ryuk does is that he drops his death note into the human world.
Okay.
And it comes into the hands of our main lead, that is named Light.
Okay.
In the series. He's just a normal boy who is very good at his academics. He's really like a very smart individual. But when he gets this book in his hands, something in him changes. He's very particular about bringing justice to this world. And his idea of justice is to kill all those who have committed major crimes. If he gets rid of all evil, there'll be only good people in this world. And that will be a new world, is his concept.
Okay.
But
very
when,
interesting. Yeah.
You know, when you are killing so many people, there are some things that will come into play. That is, people will take notice. And that's exactly what the police force does. They take notice about him. There's this one individual named Detective whose only initial is given out. That is L. And he comes onto the case of Light.
Okay.
He is onto Light. He wants to know who this murderer is.
Okay.
And these two people, the main lead and the detective, are extremely intelligent, and their way of, like, you know, finding each other out. First, the Light wants to find out who the detective is. The detective wants to find out who the murderer is. And that is, like, it's a battle of wits that take place in this entire episode series.
Okay.
It is so, like, when this is very simple plot, it's like a detective game almost.
Right.
But the dramatization of the entire series is what really captivates you the entire time. The way they have narrated a very simple tale, like even in the first episode, you think that, you know, okay, if one person is killing him, it's so easy to catch him. But the way to note down, like, in the entire world, who is responsible for these anonymous deaths, the way they pinpoint and narrow down this one individual, it's a very well thought out investigation. Alongside, you cannot underestimate the lead at all. He, some way or the other, always has like an upper hand in the situation.
Okay.
He ends up, like, you know, having, like, he's like, I've thought this out too. If, you know, plan A doesn't work out, plan B will, plan C will. He has so many plans in mind.
Right.
He's always one step ahead. So he's able to, like, you know, it's like literally a cat and mouse game between the detective and the lead.
But tell me, how is the story paced across 26 episodes? I mean, have they maintained that fast-paced, narrative, or does it drag? Because 26 episodes is a little too long, you know? So how did you find the pacing of the story?
I found the pace is, like, it's well executed. It's not dragged. I would not say it is dragged. But it is an elaborate story. It is an elaborate story. It's not like, you know, in six episodes, one person is like, he's finally caught. But the things that come into play, the characters, there is a point where the lead, that is the lead detective, L, he is almost like, he, I don't want to spoil it, but he almost comes out of the story line in a way.
Okay.
And there is someone else that takes over on his behalf. So I think at that particular moment, like that one episode, you feel it is like stretched, but it is necessary to knit the plot in. So you will watch it because you are very curious to know, okay, like, where is this heading? So even if the number of episodes is long, but that curiosity is held on. It genuinely is held on, like the entire way. In the very first episode, you think that, you know, what is giving this particular person so much confidence? Why is he like, okay, fine, understandable, he's top in his class, he's really smart, but how is he able to understand, you know, what is it about the police force, what's happening over there? How can one normal student, a high school going student, have that much intellect? That's when you realize that he has a connection at the police force. There's someone, his father works in the police force, and then you're like, okay, so he has some intel, he has something. So there are ways that the story goes that they are taking his help. The murderer almost is helping the detective, which is very unconventional. But the way it has been narrated out, it's like this murderer has been alongside the detective for so long, yet he has no way to prove that this person is the murderer. Like you have the murderer, but you don't have a way to prove it. And you're getting closer and closer. So that is very enticing.
It's amazing. An anime series has such depth in it. I mean, that is really brilliant. What did you think about the animation, so to speak?
It is fabulous. I never thought that an animated series could have such great, like, I always thought, you know, animated would be very cartoonish. It would be, you know, like, it would seem so imaginary. But the way they've shown expressions, and they have used the fact of, like, you know, being able to draw these characters, especially the Death Squad and everything, their characters and the way it has been drawn, the visual is so good. There's this one, in the very first episode, there's this one scene where Light is finding out, you know, how he can use this Death Notebook, and he writes this random person's name. And the way the very first person dies, it's like a bus running into him. That scene, it's like a, it's in slow motion, and it's like so impactful. And the music at the same time, the choreography of the entire scene really like mesmerizes you. And I would suggest you watch it like on a good big screen.
Okay.
Because it is so worth the watch. You'll be mesmerized by the visual the entire time.
I will. Which is your best scene in this entire series? One scene that you can watch again and again. Do you have one?
The most famous one is a potato chip scene that everyone literally, like, you go onto YouTube and you just write potato chip Death Note, you will find that scene because it's so raved. It's literally the character eating a potato chip and at the same time doing multiple things.
Okay.
That is what, and the way it has been directed, like the camera movements and everything, it is excellent. I loved it. I genuinely loved it.
Okay.
But my personal... Yes.
My
personal favorite is in episode 7, where it's this one scene where Light is almost going to get caught by this woman who is literally kind of onto him. She has certain proof that if she submits it to the police, you know, she he will get caught definitely.
Yeah.
So his So his way of having the conversation with her without giving away that he's the murderer, and he tricks her, that it's a good, like, I think it's a 9-minute scene. But the way he does that, you understand the wit of the character. You understand how exactly how intelligent this person is.
Let me tell you, Kavya, you can write a thesis on Death Note. I mean, given the kind of information that I have. lastly, tell me, did you binge watch the entire series? Did you finish it at one go? Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Superb. Chaliye, jaane se pehle, Kavya, kitna stars dengi aap out of 5 for Death Note?
I would give it 5.
Oh, yes, 5 out of 5. That's wonderful. I'll make sure to catch this series. But thank you very much, Kavya. Dosto, ye tha hamara review of Death Note. Agar aapne dekha hai Death Note, I'm sure bahut sare logon ne dekha hai. Please likh kar bataiye aapka kya take hai series ko lekar. Chaliye, for the moment, it's time for me and Kavya to say ta-da.